If you've ever used Adobe Character Animator before, you know how fun and accessible it is to get into the world of character animation. But as you explore a little more, you might see how deep and potentially complicated some of these actions can be. For example, if you're making a recording with multiple tracks and blending them together, or you're rigging a puppet with hundreds of layers and trying to keep track of everything. Wouldn't it be nice if there was a way to just pick a puppet, make a recording, add some triggers and emotions, and export out a video? And even better, wouldn't it be great if all that was free? Well, I'm happy to announce that this is a new feature we're working on called Starter Mode. So today, Starter Mode launches in the Character Animator beta application. So if you don't know about the Character Animator beta, you can go to this website and it's going to teach you more about Starter Mode. And there's a whole section there about how to join the beta and get started. So to test this out, you actually don't need to be a paid Character Animator user. You can just have an Adobe ID, download the Creative Cloud installer, download the Character Animator beta, and you're good to go. All right, so for me though, I'm starting here in the regular Character Animator home screen, and this is now what we are calling Pro Mode. So basically there are two modes of the app now, Pro Mode, which is the one you all know already with all full bells and whistles, and then Starter Mode, which is a more streamlined experience. So the homepage has changed a little bit here. So we've got Puppet Maker down here as the first example puppet to make your own custom puppets. And then there's this new card right here saying Explore Starter Mode. So I could either click on this or I can always go up to this new icon up here in the upper right corner to switch between app modes. And if I click on this, I get a little visual indication of the two different modes. Do I want to do Pro Mode or Starter Mode? Now, if I am a free user, I'm only going to see Starter Mode here as my main option. And then it would give me a chance to do a 7-day free trial for the Pro Mode or to go ahead and, you know, buy the full subscription if you're wanting to. So it's a way to kind of test and see how things are going. And then if you want more functionality, you can always upgrade to the Pro Mode. But if I'm a pro user, I have full access to Starter Mode as well at any time. So I can go ahead and click on Use Starter. All right, so now I've launched into a simpler version of the home screen. There's just a couple of cards up here and just a few puppets. We're hoping to have more in the future for the public release, but for right now, these are the ones that we're showing. It says select a puppet to start. Now, all of these puppets are slightly different variations from the ones in Pro Mode. They're fine-tuned to work a little bit easier and faster and be a little bit more accessible for Starter Mode. And I'll show you what I mean about that in a second. So I could choose any of these characters. Let's go ahead and just choose this guy, Leonard, right here. And selecting the character takes me into a simplified interface. So if you look at this, there's not a lot of the text and panels and stuff that are in the normal Pro Mode. All I see is my camera, the character over here, and I can already start moving around and interacting with the face and the voice and the eyes and all of that. And then I see two simple buttons down here, start recording or import dialogue audio. So this gives me two options. I can just go ahead and click start recording and record a performance. Or if I have a audio recording of myself or someone else that I want to use as my audio track, I can import that in first, take care of all my lip sync, and then record a face performance over top of it. We also have a few icons over here that give you a few additional options. This first one here is for aspect ratio. So if I wanted to change to portrait or square, I can select that and have my character's scene look like that if I'm uploading to, you know, a particular place in social media, something like that. Next up is a background option where I can select between a bunch of different backgrounds that I can play around with, or I can go down here to different colors and just have some solid colors that I can use as well. And then this settings icon is kind of a consolidated way to check out your different webcams. So if you have multiple webcams set up, you could select it here. You have a mirror camera input. And then if your microphone isn't working, you can click this to get to your audio settings and make sure that your microphone is set up correctly. We also have the calibrate button, which you should always click right before you're doing a recording to make sure your character is centered. And then this little green indicator that's again a little more streamlined version of the audio indicator of how loud your voice is for the lip sync. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get started here. I'm just gonna click and record a short, maybe 30-second recording of myself talking about Starter Mode as this character. So I'll click start recording, get a little countdown. Hey, how's it going? My name's Leonard, and I am one of the first puppets in the new Character Animator Starter Mode. It's pretty exciting. It's pretty interesting. I don't really know what's going to happen next after I press finish recording, but we're about to find out. All right, see you later. Bye. So once I'm done with that recording step, I'm taken to a second screen, and this is where we're going to start editing our experience and adding a few extra things to make it a little bit more interesting. So the first thing I notice is that I've got my full recording down here in the timeline, and it's a very simplified timeline. It's just one bar down here. And I've got these little trim handles on the side that I can move in if there's some dead air at the beginning and end, just to make that a little bit nicer. If I messed up and want to start over again, I can always click the delete icon right here to go back to the recording state. But my absolute favorite part of this mode is this section over here. And it says drag and drop triggers into the timeline. And we see all these buttons up here. Now, triggers work a little bit differently in starter mode than they do in the pro mode of Character Animator. And that is, as you roll over them, you will get a preview of what they look like. So you can very quickly see all these different actions that your character might have. So this, you know, there's quite a few different things that he's doing, different arm movements, different things he does, a nice little dance animation there, all these sorts of things. And if I want to add them into, you know, my scene, all I have to do is click and drag them and bring it down here. And now I get a little icon showing me where that emotion, that trigger begins. And then I can adjust it here by changing the duration of this this yellow overlay that appears. And if I wanted to move this a little bit later, I could do that, or earlier, or make it shorter or longer. I have full control over all of this. So at the beginning, I said, you know, hi, how's it going? My name's Leonard. So I probably want a wave there. So this wave animation looks good. So I'm going to drag this in, put it at the beginning. And that's a little too long for what I want. So I'm going to do something like this, bringing it in. And I'm just going to keep playing around with this and trying out different poses and different expressions to keep things visually interesting. So I went ahead and dragged a bunch of these into my timeline. If I didn't like one, I can always select it and press delete to get rid of it. We also have undo and redo buttons up here if you accidentally make a mistake. And I can just go ahead and play this back. Click the little play button or the space bar. And now I see my original performance with all these additional triggers over top of them to give my character a little bit of extra expressiveness. This is a really fun part of the process where you can choose, you know, how your character is feeling for the different things you're saying and really help them come to life. And it's nice that you don't really have to worry about, you know, what key you're pressing or if your arms are moving or anything like that. All that stuff is just taken care of here in the trigger system. And each of these characters has been fine-tuned to make this look as good as we possibly can. So let's say I've now reviewed this, everything's looking great, I'm ready to share this as a video. I can go up to the share icon, and if I click on this, it's gonna bring up this little quick export window. So in the past, you've always had to go to Adobe Media Encoder to export out a video. Now, if you wanna just quickly export a video directly from the app, you can do that. And this is happening in pro mode as well as starter mode. So everyone gets the benefit of this. So it's gonna put out a high quality MP4 as its default, but of course you can change if you want a smaller file for, you know, emailing or text messaging or something like that. You have that as an ability. And that looks good. I could change the location if I wanted, but then I can just go ahead and click on export. And it's gonna go through the process of exporting out the scene that I just created. And there you go. My scene has been saved to my desktop and I can play it back. And there it is, ready to upload or share or do whatever I want with it. Or maybe I finish this and I say, you know what, there's some extra stuff I want to do in pro mode to kind of finish it up. So I can actually take this project and switch to pro mode. And now I've got my recording in pro mode with all my behaviors, all my triggers, everything else if I wanted to do more with it. So we're really excited to give everyone a sneak peek into this new mode. We think this is a great way to get a lot of new users into the world of animation. And we can't wait to hear how it goes. So Try it out yourself, but also try it with friends, family, kids, dogs, cats, whatever. Have them try to create a animation and see how it goes. And let us know the feedback. Are there any parts that are confusing? Are there any features that you think are must-have things that we need for a full release launch? Let us know. The best place to go is on that website I mentioned earlier. There is a link there to give us feedback in the forums. And if you do that, that's a great place for us to have all the data, all the feedback, and myself or other people from the team can respond to you as well and let you know what we're thinking about that. So have fun. We can't wait to see what everyone makes. And if you do make a video, we'd love to see it. Please share it on social media with hashtag character animator. That's the best way for us to see it on TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all of those different places. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching and have fun.